Hello. Today we will talk about the method of conjugate gradients. We already discussed two methods for unconstrained minimization of smooth functions of several variables: gradient descent and Newton method. Gradient descent is simplest and basic method when we just go in direction of minus gradient with certain step size and compute gradient in new point and continue so on. Disadvantage of this method, like we learned, it may converge very slow when the function looks as a narrow valley, and the linear convergence rate of gradient method is 1 minus ratio of minimal to maximal eigenvalue of the Hessian. So if this ratio is like 1/1000, the method may become converging really slow. The Newton method doesn't have this disadvantage. It is much faster in terms of number of iterations. It has even quadratic convergence. On the other side, it requires evaluation of Hessian matrix, which takes n square elements of storage, n square numbers for storage. And in order to solve linear Newton system of equation, we need n cubed divided by 6 operations for Cholesky factorization. In this situation, we cannot solve problem with more than 10,000 or 100,000 variables. Conjugate gradient method brings a compromise, a kind of compromise between gradient descent and Newton method. It has a linear convergence rate 1 minus square root of ratio of minimal to maximal eigenvalue of Hessian. For example, if this ratio is 1/1000, here we will get about 1/30, so it will be about 30 times faster than gradient descent. When objective function is quadratic, it even may converge accurately in just n steps. On the other hand, the cost of one iteration, it's one gradient evaluation, but it requires exact line search. In case of quadratic function, exact line search may be performed analytically. In general case, it may require several steps of quadratic or cubic interpolation.